On today's episode, green hydrogen for ammonia energy, and NASA throws a dart at an asteroid. Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. The prospect of an asteroid crashing into the Earth has been a staple of science fiction for decades, and it's been a leading theory about mass extinction events millions of years ago. But could it happen in our lifetime? And if we can see it coming, what can we do about it? Well, NASA has just launched an experimental mission called DART, or Double Asteroid Redirection Test, to determine if a satellite can be used to deflect an asteroid or comet from an Earth collision path. Launched November 24th on a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket, the test aircraft will intercept an asteroid that is not a threat to Earth, with the goal of changing its trajectory enough to be measured with ground-based telescopes. The test, built and managed by the Johns Hopkins Applied Physics Laboratory in Laurel, Maryland, is ambitious. The DART spacecraft will autonomously navigate to the target asteroid called Dimorphos and collide with it with enough force to change its trajectory noticeably and to create a debris cloud. Dimorphos is a moonlet of a larger asteroid, Didymos, which is approximately 2,500 feet in diameter. The European Space Agency will attempt to detect the collision displacement with a ground-based telescope approximately 4 years after the impact. To photograph the actual collision, the spacecraft will also eject Giga cube, a cubesat provided by the Italian Space Agency. Another forward-looking technology will also be tested on the mission, ion thrusters. Powered by a pair of 20-foot-long roll-out solar arrays, the Aerojet Rocketdyne-built Evolutionary Xenon Thruster Commercial, or NEXT-C, prototype is expected to be a new class of propulsion systems for deep space exploration, offering low levels of thrust, but for sustained periods of time, delivering ultimately much higher spacecraft velocities than conventional chemical rockets in long-duration missions. If the DART mission succeeds, this could form the basis for the first planetary defense system against a threat from space. If you like this show, be sure to subscribe to our channel and click on the notification bell for our next episode. Fuel cells were once touted as the CO2-free alternate energy source of the future, at least before Tesla came along. But the technology has never really gone away. In fact, it has advanced for many applications, and it still shows promise for many power needs. Latham, New York-based Plug Power Incorporated, a green hydrogen development company, announced several interesting developments in this space. The company has opened a green hydrogen and fuel cell gigafactory in Rochester, New York, and has completed the acquisition of Applied Cryotechnologies, a tech and service provider for storage and distribution of cryogenic gases, including liquid hydrogen. Now, the company previously inked a deal with French hydrogen startup Lhyfe to co-develop green hydrogen plants in Europe. Now, there's a lot going on at Plug Power, but perhaps the most interesting development is a deal with multinational consortium Fertiglobe to provide technology for a 100-megawatt electrolyzer to produce green hydrogen gas at a facility in Ain Sokhna in Egypt. The hydrogen will be used as a feedstock for up to 90,000 tons of annual production of green ammonia for the Egypt Basic Industries Corporation. EBIC is a maker of fertilizer, and ammonia is an important global commodity in that sector, but the system has interesting implications for other carbon-neutral purposes. Green ammonia can be used as a carrier fuel to store and transport hydrogen, and can itself be used as a fuel for internal combustion engines and for fuel cells. Ammonia is attractive as a fuel. With an energy density of 12.7 megajoules per liter, it is significantly more energy dense than even liquid hydrogen, which is at 8.5 megajoules per liter. And ammonia can be stored at commercial refrigeration temperatures, minus 33 C, rather than the deeply cryogenic minus 253 C required for liquid hydrogen. Ammonia is also less flammable than hydrogen, although it is toxic. Can ammonia play a part in future green energy systems? Well, it has one other advantage compared to other renewables in development. The world already manufactures 180 million metric tons of it every year for industrial use and for fertilizer, so the infrastructure is already in place. Well, that's it for today's episode of This Week in Engineering, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future and Designing the Future, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.